Bienvenidos otra vez a ¿Qué pasa, Polk? Así que ahora, antes de nosotros regresar, estábamos bromeando de ciertas cosas, de diferentes cosas que yo he hecho durante los 8 años de este programa. Pero hoy estoy con mi productor aquí, con Steven Barnes, que es mi producer, y él va conmigo en la nostalgia. Vamos a coger un carrito de Nostalgia Car y vamos a hablar de diferentes cosas y cosas muy importantes todavía que son vigentes durante este tiempo con esta pandemia. Así que bienvenidos a ¿Qué pasa, Polk, Steven?
Gracias, thank you, thank you. It's good to be here.
So what it's
kind of weird being on this side of it. You know, I'm always back in the control room or behind cameras and everything. So
how have you been able to put up with me in 8 years?
Well, I will tell you, you certainly do not lack in providing entertainment. That's for sure. You always keep us laughing. I love it.
So how do you think I've changed in the 8 years? Because obviously...
Well, you know, when we started this, there's a lot that's been changed, actually. You remember our first couple shows, the studio was totally different.
Yep.
We didn't really have a solid set. We used a lot of fabric to drape, mm-hmm. and we kind of used what we had at the time.
Improvised.
Yeah, and we've certainly grown to different decorations throughout the year. But, yeah, you've gone through a lot of change. Now, the thing that interests me the most, the thing that I find the most interesting is, you know, all of your different style changes. It seems like you're always changing your style, like even from show to show, just like 2 weeks and you come in a different hairstyle. And of course you have like a background in the fashion industry, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I graduated from Trapp Hagen School of Fashion and I worked as a children's wear designer for over 25 years in New York. So I was a garmento, that's what they called us. And I found myself trying to keep up with trends or making my own trend, as you just acknowledged there. I always like to keep things spicy, just like I do with my husband. It's like when I walk in, you know, he says, oh my goodness, there's a new woman in my house. It's like, you know, so I expect for him to say something positive.
Yeah.
But thank God, yes, he has. Así que ahora vamos a hablar de otros temas importantes. Esto, vamos a hablar del census, que se caduca ahora la fecha en octubre 31. Así que si, ustedes saben que este condado le ha dado mucho dinero por muchos programas. Esa es la situación. Tienes que dejarte ser contado para que el condado reciba dineros federales para ayudarlo, especialmente ahora mismo durante esta pandemia. Así que, so Steve, we're having the deadline coming up soon.
Yeah, and like you said, it is absolutely necessary to make sure that you've filled out that census. The deadline is coming, and it's going to be the last opportunity that we have to get a good calculation of who's here. And that's not just for the money. We talk about the money all the time. It's not just for the money. We've also got, there's the possibility of us getting new seats, which would give us more voting power as a state when it comes to election time. So all of these things are all part
crucial.
Of the census, and it is crucial. And one of the things that I think is really interesting, we saw this in the last census 10 years ago, is the increase in Hispanic population.
Yes.
And we really want to be able to calculate that. We want to see how many of our residents here in Polk County are minorities, how many are Hispanic, how many are black, how many are from other countries. So, you know, at the beginning of it, there was a lot of concern about the safety of the census, of that information being safe and secure. And, you know, if you sign up for the census and you're not maybe a legal citizen or whatever, but you're still using the resources of our county. And as long as you're here, you need to be counted. And
that's
the big thing.
Yes, that's extremely important. I found that a lot with a lot of people that I would talk to at the flea markets and stuff like that, because that's like a particular area where a lot of people who really are not residents who go and congregate. And I brought it up to a couple that was sitting down having a lunch with their kids and stuff, and I asked them, have you filled out your census? And they're like, we're really not, you know, citizens. I says, yeah, but you're inhabiting a home that's probably owned. Are you renting or are you owning?
Right.
No, we're renting. So whoever you're renting it from, it's an American citizen.
Right.
And that's their property, but you are inhabiting that dwelling. They're not. You are voting.
Yeah. We're on the tails of the end of the census comes the big election.
Yeah. Yes, it does. And we are, obviously, we already completed registration. And so now it's early voting time, and that's coming around soon on the 19th of this month. So a lot of people are concerned about their mail-in ballots and these kind of things. We've had the supervisor of elections here on the show various times to explain the process, what they're doing.
And that it's extremely safe. Like, you don't have to worry about fraud here in Polk County. They've got a system. I've been doing mail-in ballots in Polk County since 2007 when I first finished up college and became a resident. It's an easy and convenient way to do it. But whether you are going to vote the day of, whether you're doing early voting, whether you're doing the mail-in voting, it's all secure. It's all a valid way to vote. Don't listen to the chatter about, you know, your vote's not going to get counted. Get it in there.
It's not going to no river.
Yeah, get it mailed in. Follow the directions, though. It is important to follow the directions. Make sure that envelope has your signature on it.
And your phone number or email.
Follow the information and fill it out the way that it's required. But yeah, absolutely critical. And there's going to be a lot of amendments on lot of amendments on the ballot. It's not just about voting for president. I know that's the big thing on this ballot.
Judges and amendments that need to be really, really looked at. And if you're not sure, look them up. Contact the party affiliation that you're with and find out more information, or just contact the supervisor of elections.
And it's important to know about these amendments ahead of time and do your research on them, because sometimes the wording on these amendments gets tricky and you think you're voting one way, you might actually be voting the other way. So make sure you understand what the amendment's about and how it's going to impact you and your community.
Exactly. Something that's important, and you know already that I went through my training. I am an official trained DS-200 equipment technician.
Now that you're retired, I have to branch out
and doing that too. But it was interesting. One of the parts of that training was those ballots that are not mailed in, but that people do bring them to drop off that day on early voting. It will be counted.
Yeah.
Okay. The other thing is that when the citizen walks in, the voter walks in, he or she will be directed to a VIS, and that person is going to have them sign in, do what they need, and they will take the ballot and put it in the box.
Yeah.
And they will show them, look, it's going in the box. And then when we're about to close the night, we start to count, make sure that all the ballots did go through. We double check before we close out the night.
Which is a great way to do that. You get your ballot in the mail. You can actually review what's on the ballot. And, you know, my wife and I, we sit and we pull up our computers and we go through each candidate and we determine who best aligns with our with our views and our, you know, how we want to see the country guided. And our community, we look up those amendments. It gives you an opportunity to really kind of study the ballot. And then you can drop it off, and you don't have to stand in line, and it's not the first time you're seeing the ballot.
And you'll be assured that you have handed it to an official of the supervisor of elections, not to a total stranger. Please don't do that. Come in and get your sticker, and excellent. So, but during now that we're having that other storm. So we had the census, and now
we had the pandemic. We have the census.
We're still, and I want people to realize that we are still in hurricane season. Right now, we outnumbered all the names, and now we're going into the Greek alphabet.
And so, even as we're taping right now, you know, there's some storm brewing in the Gulf right now,
getting ready
to slam into the Gulf Coast again. So. Yeah, we're definitely not out of the woods yet.
No, we're not.
It's
out of
easy
the woods.
To think, okay, well, you know, hurricane season's over, but it's not.
No, it's not.
It's not. And just because there's a specific date, you know, the November 1st date of the end of the season, there's still the possibility for hurricanes even.
It can go as far as the 15th.
So it's important to stay prepared, have that plan, know whether or not you're going to need to go to a shelter. Of course, our emergency management team, Paul Womble, who we've had on here in recent months, says, you know, because of the pandemic, we're encouraging people to stay home. If you can shelter at home safely, make that your plan. If you have relatives that you can go and shelter safely with, make that your plan. Make the shelter your last option.
Yeah, and don't leave it for last minute.
Right. Yep, please. Have a plan. And of course, if you're using generators, things like that, if you plan it, make sure that your generators are working and up to date. You know, go out, fire them up every now and then, make sure they're still running, because when the hurricane comes, you're not going to be able to take it to a shop and get it fixed.
Exactly. You're running around, you're trying to get, and you may skip a beat, and that's where the danger comes
in. And of course, use them safely. Know that those exhaust fumes out of those...
That has gasoline in it.
We have seen in recent years in storms that the improper use of generators is just as deadly as the storm. We've seen small children die from that carbon monoxide poisoning. We've seen people get sick and have to go to the hospital, and we definitely want to avoid that. So make sure that your exhaust is far away from the house.
Yes, and if you can't, deal with it, or you're still nervous, just have your other plan. Go stay somewhere safe.
Yeah.
Avoid any tragedies. But hurricanes are, they're a doozy, and we've had ours. Now, because of this pandemic, we've had so many people be challenged financially. Businesses, individuals, and even seniors. So I know that Polk County had a program, Polk Cares. What's the updates on that right now?
So the CARES Act, which is kind of our local, it was kind of the way we branded our local distribution of the funds that were passed down from federal and state. So we had gone through months of applications and distribution of funds. The CARES Act is now fully distributed. Yes, so there's no more applications accepting. Now, there may be some folks who have applied and are still waiting for those funds to come in. Those applications are still being processed, but we're not taking any new applications.
Exactly.
We now have enough applications to distribute all of the funding. In most cases, the funding has already been distributed.
Yes.
The CARES for Seniors.
Yes,
is a good example.
That was
as far as distribution of funds goes, that was a big success. If we had more, we could give away a lot more probably.
Yes.
But certainly, that's all been taken care of. So if folks start saying, apply for the CARES Act, we're actually finished with that.
Now, besides Que Pasa Polk, what other shows? I mean, because a lot of people think that it's only Que Pasa Polk. I mean, PGTV is known for years. I remember when I first moved here, I came on the show when I opened the chamber, and I believe we had a young lady here named by Joan Davies, and
Joan was great. Yeah.
And then I came on with Comunidad Viva with Teresa Martinez. So.
Yeah, and that was a show that ran for 7 or 8 years at least. So. There's been a long, historic kind of through line of Spanish programming here on PGTV.
But we're not the only ones. There's other great stuff.
Yeah, there are a lot of, and of course, I don't speak Spanish, so, we're doing this in English today, so I apologize. I wish I could do it.
Pero tú sabes un poquito.
Un poquito, entiendo.
Sí.
So we've got a lot of other great shows. So we have a show that brings commissioners, our board of commissioners. They come on the show. They talk about what kinds of things are going on in their districts. They bring guests on to talk about the businesses that are opening and things like that. So that's a really great show called The Commissioner's Report. We've got another one that highlights art around the community, different artists that are doing different things. And it's a really uplifting and warming show to see the kind of creativity that's here in Polk County. We've got all kinds of stuff, a sports show, a live sports show with our partners at Polk County Tourism and Sports Marketing.
Mm-hmm.
That show has been going on since, I believe, 2005.
That's so how I found out about the Dreadnoughts.
Yeah, exactly. So they cover a lot of local sports. They bring in local coaches from the universities, from the high schools, things like that. They highlight a lot of really great events. So our Sports Central has been a long, ongoing show that has been really impactful for the community. Different things like a news show. We have a news show, Crime Stoppers, bringing in, talking about, you know, what's going on in the community, what you need to be aware of, who's on the loose, you know, your eye out.
Who's on the loose? Oh my God.
Rewards that are available for information on crimes, things like that. We've got another show that's all about tourism and the different places that you can go here in Polk County, and that's always being refreshed and renewed with new places as new businesses open up, and that's called Encounter.
In that show, I found out about the different trails and things like that here, and I was like, really? Oh, wow. And I was kayaking and groves, and I was like, wow, I didn't know that. So I'm learning as I flip, you know, the channels and stuff, and learn a little bit more about my home base here.
Yeah, and that's just a little taste of what we've got. We've got roughly 12 to 13 different shows that are either semi or bi-weekly, like our show is bi-weekly, or monthly shows. Mm-hmm. In addition to that, of course, you go to polk-county.tv. The county's main website is polk-county.net. But if you go to polk-county.tv, that is the PGTV website. And you can watch live meetings there as they're happening.
That's important.
We do the live streaming, yep.
That's important to see all these live meetings at the commissioner's meetings so you can be up to date with what's going on.
Yeah, and that's one of, you know, as far as why PGTV exists, that's our main purpose, is to make sure that the meetings and the government is open and transparent to the community so that they can see what's going on and be informed. Now, we don't force people to watch it, but it's there for them to watch.
Exactly.
So, you know, if you want to be informed, PGTV is the absolute best place to go to be informed on what's going on in the county.
In the community. Oh, yes, especially in the county. A lot of people, when they move to this area, they only think of one particular city, and they forget that there are several cities within our county. And
I think 17 different municipalities and areas.
And each one has their own little government, their own, you know, they have their own little things going on, but the county is what brings us all together.
And we're seeing incredible growth up in the northeast side of the county. You know, for so long it's been Lakeland and it's been Winter Haven, and those are the two big cities, and Lake Wales, you know, Lake Wales was in the discussion of the big cities. But now we're seeing Haines City and Davenport area.
I mean,
it is just exploding up there. And exploding with Hispanic population as well. So that's a key demographic area for us that we're really reaching out to.
Oh, que pasa Polk is there all the time for
them.
That's right. So we've got that. Anything on the back burner?
Well, you know, we've got, I know you're teasing this because we've got a new show coming up. I'm not going to say too much about it, but we do have a new show coming up. Hopefully we'll see the pilot for that in December. And for those of you who are loving to watch our lovely Miss Anna Rivera, she will be the host of this new show. So this will not be a Spanish show. It won't be in Spanish, but
I may throw a little, you know, Spanglish in there and
stuff
like that. So I can teach also a little bit of Spanish.
Well, you are who you are, right? You are who you are.
So. I'm a girl from the Bronx. What can I say?
But no, we're excited about new things coming. And speaking of new things, you know, we have this year has been a weird year, right?
I mean, to say the least.
You know, organizations have been doing fundraisers and events and things like that since they started, and this year they have not been able to do those types of things. So one of the things that we've as PGTV have been able to do is kind of help some of those organizations, and we've got some things on the books to help out, you know, creating new opportunities for them via virtual award ceremonies, virtual fundraising events, things like that, where we can't gather 300 to 700 people at an event anymore. So, you know, we're trying to use our resources to help some of these nonprofit agencies continue to do their fundraising and continue to get their message out, because the work they do, even though their events aren't happening, the work they're doing is still continuing, and I know that you see that even with your chamber.
Yes, we're having our moments where we're like, okay, so how can we think outside of the box? And I mentioned previously that the Galleon Awards has always been a celebration right. of our members and those who have been top members in the year. That's going to have to be virtual. You know, it's like da 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 with some background, you know, trumpet music, and then just, you know, and show whoever is the winner and stuff. So.
And I think a lot of times people see, you know, when they think of PGTV, they think of you know, the government agency, you know, that covers government stuff, and we only do government things. But, you know, we've had a long-standing show called Polk Place. That has brought in, again, one of our longest running shows, as long as I've been here, even as an intern back in 2007, you know, they were running Polk Place. So bringing nonprofit agencies in to talk about what they're doing and the good work that they're doing. And I think that those agencies are what makes Polk County, you know, a great place to live. That's one thing that never escapes me, and I'm always amazed at, is the generosity of the people of Polk County.
Yes.
To support these agencies, to support the good work that's going on. You know, we talk about government and, you know, the different programs that we have and things like that, but it's never going to be enough to meet the needs of the community. And that's where our nonprofit agencies in Polk County that we can partner with and get the work done.
Yes. We can do this, we will survive this, and we will always be here for you. PGTV is your TV station for you, for your community. We have all the resources that you need to know about living in your community and how you can survive with everything that's going on today. Mm-hmm. So please, just like my producer Steven just said, there are information on our website. Always watch everything. It's great information because it affects you here, not in Hollywood or in New York. Mm-hmm. It's here in Polk County. So what can I say? Eso es todo por hoy. Voy a seguir comiendo mi pastel. Así que han sido 8 años. Y si Dios y la Virgen nos permite, estaremos aquí 8 años más. Así que esto ha sido ¿Qué pasa hoy? En nuestro programa de aniversario, aquí yo con mi productor, el señor Steven Barnes, que él es mi codo, mi jefe, siempre me apoya y apoya a nuestra comunidad. He's my boss here, and he is always supporting every crazy thing that I come up with, and also our community here. He's got great shows for you, so please always stay tuned. I love you. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you soon. So enjoy your month. Don't forget to vote. Don't forget to finish your census. I don't want to have to stop you in Walmart. Okay? Así que Dios me los cuide. Esto ha sido todo hoy en ¿Qué pasa?